So the first hole here, like I said before, is a 515 yard par 5. It's probably the shortest one on the course. It is downhill too. But today, it's into the wind, it's cold, it's a very cloudy day. It doesn't look like the sun's gonna come out. I'm working on my starting point. Lately, I've been starting in the middle of the fairway and either putting a cut or a draw on it. But the shot shapes are good. It's just, when I wanna play a cut, I need to start, obviously, in the left side of the fairway, or if I wanna play a draw on the right side. So today I'm working on that, and also picking the better side to miss. If there's OB right, like there is on this hole, there's nothing left, you wanna miss left if there is one. So we're gonna play a baby fade, starting it up the left side of the fairway, and the wind is also coming from the right, so it'll kind of cancel a little bit of my fade out. I can't see over the hill here, but it is a good line. It's exactly what I wanted to do. So, in the middle of the fairway, in the fairway, first hole, first drive, not a bad start. So I got 240 yards here. My drive didn't go anywhere. It is cold, the air's thicker. I was slightly into the wind and the fairways are wet because it rained this morning. So I'm gonna hit a 3-wood, try to hit a nice high draw, starting at that bunker just right of the pin and bringing it to the left side of the green. That would leave me an uphill putt. And obviously it's par 5, so it would be 2 putts for birdie. I might not get there again because it is just goes to these conditions. Damn. Didn't really draw there. I did hit it good. So it's in that right bunker there. It's just a short-sided bunker shot. I can land it past and it will fade back to the pin because this green is front is a flat part. Middle pin would be on a plateau here. And you'll see it when I'm up there. And the back is another flat part. So luckily, the pin's at the front.
Well, Carl's a bit hard on himself here. He had 240 yards to the pin, uphill, and into the breeze on a freezing cold day. I think he's actually done fairly well. He's less than 10 yards short of his intended target there.
Well, I've got a short-sided bunker shot here. Like I said, this green is weird. You'll see a lot of the greens out here at Tangle Creek. They're very challenging, so it's really critical where you put the ball. So here, if I was smart, if I had a miss, it would be long and the ball would feed down a little, but it would still be about 10, 15 feet away, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna land it about 3 feet short and let it check up. So as you can see there, the bunker had no sand in it. It was really hard. And my wedge is the EF Grind New TaylorMade wedge, but it's the ATV bounce and the ATV grind, and it just doesn't get under the hard surfaces in a bunker. And I've had it happen a few times lately. So I'm just waiting on my new ones that are coming in a lower bounce, and that has a sharper edge, so it'll be able to get under the hard, any type of bunker a lot easier, so that won't happen as much. So for right now, have to do what you gotta do, I guess, and get it out as close as possible. So here, these greens are kinda quick usually, but today they're slower. Well, on the putting green they were slower, and So the ball is going to break a little bit more because I got it hit a little harder. And I just want to walk off with two putts here and make a par on the first hole. Putt par, first hole, even through one. Second hole here is a 360-yard par four. It's basically a dead straight fairway. There's no doglegs in it. There is OB right and just rough down the left. Again, this is a funky green. And you gotta really pick where you wanna hit the ball. So here I'm gonna hit a nice, like exactly the same as the last hole. Start up the left of the cut and the wind should bring it back. So I teed the ball down a little here because it's into the wind and the ball will start off lower in the face. So that one didn't really cut back. It's in the left rough, but it's fine there. I'll have less than 100 yards in, hopefully, and should be able to get to sit because there is another backstop. So just want to let you guys know that you guys write comments on YouTube, and I'm not the one that answers them. My dad does. I better spend my time practicing than dealing with most of my social media. And I just don't really have the time to answer all those comments on YouTube and practice at the same time and try to get better. So my dad takes care of that. And if you do a comment, my dad is going to answer it. So just letting you know that. And I also do have Twitter and Instagram. My usernames are in the description below. Follow me on both of those. And hopefully I can get the same amount of followers on like Instagram as I have as many subscribers on YouTube. That would be nice. On my YouTube, I don't really put in the things I do off the course. I do put that stuff on my Instagram, so if you go follow me, you will be able to check that out. My user will be public. I'm gonna change it from private to public because I get a lot of follow requests, and I don't have a phone anymore, but I do use another device to do that, but I only get to check it every now and then. So if you want to see other things that I do, just follow me on Instagram, or if you want, you can follow me on Twitter too. But anyways, here I have 85 yards. There is a backstop behind the pin in the rough, so there will be a little bit of top spin. I'm gonna land it short of the pin and let it release. Hopefully I can get it close and make a par or birdie. Didn't exactly release the way I wanted to. Kind of checked up on me. So that's a lesson to be learned for the rest of the holes, that the greens are not releasing today. I haven't played this course in a while, so last time they were releasing today, obviously they're not. I got about 15 feet there for birdie, uphill putt. Obviously that's what I was trying to lead myself with. didn't break the way I thought it would. So just a two putt. Par, even through two. So this grass on these greens here at Tangle Creek is called Poa Anua grass. You find it in California or in Canada. Most of the courses I've played has it. It's very different in the fact that later in the day it gets very bumpy. If you watched my video from San Diego when I played Junior Worlds, I was missing a lot of four, three, five foot putts, whatever, anything that was short. And if you watched the fries.com open last week in San Diego, in California, the best players in the world were missing short putts just because it's unpredictable what the Poa is going to do. It's only later in the day where it gets really challenging. In the morning, the greens appear, but it's just the advantage of having a morning tee time really affects what you score. I mean, it's different. I don't know if you guys have played on it, but it's really different. And also, the greens up here in Canada have all been aerated within the last 2 weeks. These ones were aerated a couple weeks ago. As you can see, the holes in them are still visible. Literally, the courses here in Canada or in Barrie, I've seen they're all shutting down for the winter holidays because the courses, it snows and they're just, I guess they're too hard to maintain and it's unplayable because it's freezing and nobody wants to come out anyway. So they just shut the courses down. So this is going to be my last week of playing in Canada. Hopefully I get my visa done so I can get back to Florida and play in the warmer weather. So the third hole here is a 399 yard par 4. Dogleg right, water on the right side. Pin's on the left. I've never played it with the pin on the left. I don't know. I can't tell you anything about it, but up on this hole, starting it up the left with a baby cut is better than starting it up the right with a draw, because if it doesn't draw, you're in the water. If it doesn't fade, when you start at the left, you're in the bunker. Which would you take, a penalty or just being in the bunker? Down the middle, have a good shot at the green. Didn't really fade. I kind of hit a little straight. I don't know. I wasn't really intending to do that, but I'll take it. It was dead straight down the middle. Not complaining. It's like 108 yards. I'm gonna play a choke down gap wedge because a full 54 would go really high, and because it's a back pin, it would spin all the way to some like 30 feet away. So I'm gonna hit as I explained in one of my other videos, a shot that takes the spin off and also takes off the distance. So, but you can't see the whole entire green, so I'm gonna get my dad to go up there so he can film my shot landing, because I can't see it, but once my dad's up there, you guys will be able to see it, and my dad will give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down if it's good.
See if we can get this. Yeah, that's a good shot. Smart shot by Carl. He got the yardage right on there.
As you can see, I'm playing by myself, and you might think that there's no pressure, but there is pressure. My dad puts a lot of it on me. He puts pressure on me because he wants it to feel as if when I get to a tournament that it's no different than when I go out and play with my dad. So I don't feel a lot of pressure when I go into tournaments. Obviously, if I'm leading coming to the last hole of a major tournament, I'm going to feel some, but I handle a lot better than other people I've seen.
And you,
So we got about 10 to 15 feet here, birdie. It breaks left to right. It's a little uphill. And see, I can make a birdie. I swear that was gonna break to the right. Apparently you can't do this if you're in someone's way in a tournament and you're just doing it to speed up play, you can tap it in like that. But if there's no, if you're the last person to putt out and you do this, it's illegal. Isn't that dumb? This hole is it says 170 on the sheet, but front pin, I don't know. And here we have 154 yards. Pin must be it's a pretty big green, I must say. At 170 to the center, so it's 16 yards. Shorter than the center of the green. It looks a lot longer, but it's not. So I'm gonna hit a choke down 7 and try to hit a nice little draw in there to counteract the wind. Hopefully it should be the right club. Thank you.